Hey everyone, welcome to round two. We have won the roll, so we're gonna go ahead and play first. What do we have? We have a hand that's got some stuff, so I guess we can go ahead and keep this. Maybe we'd like to mulligan. Nope. Terramorphic into mountain, then play island. Well, we can play Terramorphic on turn two, but if we draw a suspend creature on turn two, then we kinda wanna play that, and we can play pier maybe. Although with Desperate Ritual already in our hand, I kinda wanna just hold that, so let's go ahead and just crack this for a mountain. It does reduce the percentage slightly that we end up drawing a land for our third draw step, or for our second draw step, which would be on our third turn. But I think the upside of being able to play like a redundant Pier Through Depths is a little bit better, so we'll just go ahead and crack that for our mountain now. And there's an island, so we can go ahead and Pestermite on his upkeep on turn three. And I'm going to hold off on this pier for now. See, we do have other piers to draw into, an Ethereum Sculptor. So I think we're probably going to lock down his island. And we've got nothing going on, so we'll go ahead and do that. Tap his island. Do we want to do tap it? Yeah, kind of. At this point, I actually might just trade. Not really. It's worth getting two damage, so we'll just go ahead and not trade there. Don't really know how good this guy is going to be, although, I mean, in an Infinity deck, this should be pretty good. Apocrysite, and, oh gosh, it knows. Pepper Smoke, Mirror Retriever. So, a bunch of nonsense. Alright, so I think what I'm going to do is actually just cast Pier, and then there isn't really too much of a disadvantage to not reveal the Desperate Ritual, so that will make the pure cost basically one mana. So if we end up drawing into a Warrens, then that'll be pretty good, I think. Alternatively, we can just attack and pass, but I kind of want to use this turn, so let's go ahead and see what's up, because we can play Pierce plus Splice Ritual. We'll have three floating. And if we end up drawing a Warrens, then we can just go ahead and play it for six. That's kind of mediocre, I guess. But we don't have to do anything, so let's go ahead and see what's up. There's another Desperate Ritual. Well, we're taking that, obviously. Putting the Cloud Skate and some lands on the bottom. So we can go and just pass the turn now, I guess. Or alternatively, we can just play Manamorphose into Desperate Ritual and appear, but we don't have any Warrens yet, so we need to see it in six cards, basically. We know that it's going to be, there are four on the bottom that are not empty the Warrens, so it's one, and basically, we're seeing six cards, we're seeing a quarter of our deck for a two of, so that's about, and that's going to be just under 50%, but basically, we're at three mana, so this would be four mana, five mana. The problem is, if we cast Pier, we're going to be down to three mana, so I think we just want to actually just pass the turn here, because we won't be able to cast both Pier and Warrens. So we'll take the stop off of his upkeep and just take some damage. There's no reason to pull the trigger now. Not really under any pressure. I mean, it's just three damage a turn, sure, but unless you play something scary. And let's see, that is Beyond Abysmal. So let's see, Manamorphose. So now here I think we can probably just, let's see. We can either wait, or we can attack, or we can try and find Grape Shot. He's got three cards. I mean, we can just trade Pestermite for Latchkey Fairy. I mean, we can just pass the turn. We can just torrent that. and attack. I think that's actually fine. I like that a little bit better. Or we can save torrent for something else. Who knows? I mean, this thing is just not really a threat. We can, unless we are actually going to kill with grape shot, then I think it's worth just holding. If we're going to kill with grape shot, then we need to keep this guy on the battlefield. We don't really know what storm spell we're drawing into, so I think it's going to be best if we just get rid of that now and advance our board state in terms of the amount of damage that we need to do. It makes drawing grape shot better for us. And all the while he's going to be attacking for sure. But while he can't, if he can't attack with that, then we can attack, and so that makes our grape shot better. So it gives us more time. Because if he attacks with the Latchkey Fairy, then I really want to block. He's got nothing, it seems like, up here. All right, well, we can go ahead and spew that one off. See if he does anything. We can still splice on Desperate Ritual, because unless he's going to counter it this turn, then it's only bad. Playing Pier now is only bad if he has two counter spells, and that doesn't seem like it's going to be that much of a case, and that likely of a case, rather. So I feel like it's fine to actually just play Pier Splice Ritual right now. Because this, if he does have a counter spell, he might actually just counter this. And let's see, Rift Bolt or something else. Well, we can go Lava Spike. That doesn't really draw us into anything. Rift Bolt and Lava Spike are the same thing, so it's whether or not we want to actually just draw a card. I think with the amount of search that we have, we know that we know the top, the bottom eight cards. So at this point, I think I would rather just have the Reach Through Mists. And we could put Lava Spike followed by Rift Bolt followed by those, and just pass the turn here. Because now if we draw a land, then we can get Reach splicing those. The two Desperate Rituals, and then we can play Manamorphose to be able to play Pier. And I feel like he's going to want to cast something. Aether Spell Bomb. Well, that's certainly casting something. There's an island. All right. Let's go ahead and attack. Yeah, let's go ahead and cast this and start splicing, I guess. Get a draw card, get 6 mana. It's a lot of mana. Grape shot. Well, that's certainly something. All right. I think we can probably pull the trigger on this Manamorphose so we can cast Pier. Electrolyze, jeez. So now we can play Pier and splice two rituals. Do we have a Warrens? And we have a Warrens, all right. So, basically, Echoing Truth is gonna screw us, but we do have the grape shot, so what I'm gonna do is just take the Warrens, and then hopefully he doesn't have a counter, I guess. So we can draw, play Manamorphose and get double blue. And right now we're at Storm 4, so let's go ahead and cast and splice these. All right, so now what we can do is play this Desperate Ritual. So we've got 8 mana right now, this would go up to 9, so that would be all 3 spells. So I think first what we can do is, let's see, if we cast Electrolyze, that's down to 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3. So I feel like if he had Counterspell, he would have countered this Desperate Ritual. So. But it's only basically Lava Spike and Peer Through Depths that we're going to be drawing in, or Reach of the Mist. So let's just go ahead and cast this. Then we can Electrolyze his, just him, I guess. Yeah. And then we can Warrens. And then we can grape shot him. So this will take him down to 1. So if he has an Echoing Truth and some other stuff, then like he's really in a bit of a bind here. Hopefully he just doesn't have anything. He's got a Death Rattle. Well, if he has Echoing Truth here, then we're in a little bit of trouble. But he doesn't. What happens if we draw a card? Pestermite into Grapeshot. Ooh, that would have been scary. Okie dokie, so he's got some small artifact guys. He is playing blue, so that makes Empty the Warrens less good because he could have Echoing Truth, but that's just a risk that we're going to have to take. And if we have the opportunity to take different lines to go for a Grape Shot kill, then that'll be better for us. So I think we'll just submit this the way it is. We can go with maybe a Dampen Thought Petals. I'll just go ahead and try this again.